We have so much to discuss after that big win versus the 18th ranked Alabama Crimson Tide. So let's get right into it. So you see, we beat them. We're ranked number 18 now. Alcorn State took care of Mississippi Valley State. Alabama A&M beat Bethune-Cookman. Bethune-Cookman is 0-9. 0-9. Yikes. Prairie View beat Arkansas Pine Bluff 28-16. The Bayou Classic came early in November as the Southern Jaguars took care of Grambling. Jackson State and Florida A&M. Florida A&M was victorious in that one. Meanwhile, over at the MEAC in the Sun Belt, Hampton beat North Carolina A&T. Howard beat Tennessee State 37-30. Delaware State beat South Carolina State 41-28. And finally, you have Morgan State victorious over Norfolk State 28-21. Now for the players of the week. There goes Ken King once again for Alabama A&M and CJ Nixon for Alcorn State. Both players balled out. Offensive and defensive players of the week in the SWAC MAC. Meanwhile, over at the Sun Belt, aka the MEAC, Eric Hubbard and AJ Seward round out the players of the week. So the standings look like this. You see that Texas Southern is still in the lead in the East. Meanwhile, the Southern Jaguars jumped us for first place in the West. That is no surprise. We both have the same conference record, and at this rate, they could win the West if they win out. But look at this. We have a new recruit coming to town. We got the wide receiver that we wanted. Ryan Thompson is bringing his talent to the Gump Town to play for them Alabama State Hornets. Now, he has poor potential, but we're not worried about that. What I like is the fact that he has average discipline. I don't expect him to get into a lot of trouble. He has 4-3 speed, 4-3-3 to be precise, a field awareness. Look at that vertical though. A 39.8 inch vertical, almost 40 inches, A plus hands, a 215 pound bench press, but we're gonna get him strong when he comes to the Hornets. And a 350 pound squat. So this is big because we're going to be losing Kevin Scott. We're going to be losing Marcus Williams, meaning that we probably won't have no more than two dependable receivers after those two leave. What good are wide receivers when they can't catch? So Garrett Harvey gave us a soft verbal commit. Again, poor potential. That's cool. We're not worried about that. We're worried about the discipline more. Leon Hill also gave us a soft verbal commit. The middle linebacker all the way out there from California. We're hoping we'll keep that. Hopefully we can beat USC for him. Ron Lawson, another middle linebacker we want to get. But we're still battling the Tennessee Volunteers and the Auburn Tigers for him. But he's looking to make his official visit, so he's coming to the Jackson State game next week. Trey Tyler, another man looking to make his official visit. So we're going to bring him out here for the Jackson State game as well. So next week is going to be a big, big game for us as far as recruiting. So we got Ryan Thompson. We're good on that. Now I want to show you this. I want to show you how we're making noise in the record books in the NCAA football world. You see, there goes Gene Singleton with the longest run. There goes Bryant, the Alabama A&M quarterback with the longest pass in NCAA history. Longest punt return. The man all the way from VA, Justin Chambers. Neil Bryant with the longest kick return with 104 yards. That was against A&M, I believe. And then there goes Justin Scott, of course, the historic pick six versus Iowa. Look at Keldrick Williams. Who can forget about the deuce? 454 yards rushing on Alabama A&M, man. That's crazy. So as we continue to progress in this series, we're looking to see more of this. We want to see more records broken. There goes another record by the Alabama State Hornets. You see the 119 points. We did that in season one versus the Howard Bison. But yeah, oh yeah, also Chambers right now has the record for most rushing yards in NCAA history. I can't forget about that. Of course, you see he has the record for single season rushing yards, single season touchdowns. And then there goes the career record right there. That's right there. You see that? 96-99 Wisconsin. That's Ron Dayne. we're going to be breaking that record eventually as well. So he has 75 touchdown runs right now. And we still have at least five games left. That including the bowl game and, of course, the conference championship game if we make it. So, Justin Chambers, under 93 carries, has over 1,000 yards, averaging almost 12 a carry, 360 after contact this season, along with 14 touchdown runs. This season is far from over. We do have three games left in the regular season, though, and we still need to see what Southern's going to do. But Justin Chambers still has a chance to get 2,000 yards rushing for back-to-back seasons. That right there alone is a huge accomplishment in college football. But now we have some breaking news out of the Alabama State football program. Bobby Newton will be starting. He will be starting for the remainder of the season. Joseph Cooley loved what he saw from him against Alabama. He liked what he saw from him in practice this week. And now Bobby Newton is no doubt the man once again. Now, would this be a guarantee that he will be the man in season five? Absolutely not. Chase Herron, the Duke Blue Devil transfer, he's coming in next year. And he's already rated higher than Bobby Newton. And I think he has the better arm. The only thing with Chase is he needs to work on that accuracy just like Newton does. But he's already a step ahead. But this is no doubt one of Bobby Newton's best performances of the season. He played great against Alabama. He played great against Prairie View. Those, in my opinion, were his best two games. But now we need him to finish out strong in his junior year. The next set of news, Jason White, one of our starting wide receivers, is out for the rest of the season. And I forgot to mention this after we lost to Southern. So on this play, this is where he got injured and dislocated his elbow. Unfortunately for Jason White, he hasn't had the best season. By the time he's healed, the season will be over. So we're going to be looking for Tim Brown to step up in his place. But join us next time. We got them cats from Jackson, Mississippi coming to town. The Jackson State Tigers against the Alabama State Hornets. And a big time matchup that we need to win. This is a critical game. Because despite the fact that they're 3-6, they still have talent on their team. And we can't take them lightly.